गुड ईवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सिक्स्थ स्टैंडर्ड सोशल क्लास. स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल आर सेफ एट होम बाय गॉड्स ग्रेस. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द सेम लेसन, एवोल्यूशन इन हिस्ट्री यूनिट टू, इन्वेंशन ऑफ द व्हील. इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू सी इन्वेंशन ऑफ द व्हील. द इन्वेंशन ऑफ व्हील बाय ह्यूमंस इज कंसिडर्ड to be the foremost invention. Foremost invention means is a important or peculiar or special invention. When humans saw the stones rolling down from the mountains, probably they would have got the idea of making the wheel. Already we studied peoples, early man, they lived in mountains. So in that places, during rainy times, they saw the stones rolling down from the mountains. So they would have got the idea of making the wheel. Next one, pot making. Pot making. Humans learned to make pot with clay. Early men, humans learned to make pot with clay. The invention of wheel made pot easier. The invention of wheel made pot making easier, and the pots were made burnt to make it stronger. After making the pot with the clay, they burnt with fire. So this is make the pot stronger. They decorated pots with a lot of colors. They decorated pots with lot of colors. The color dyes were made from the extract of roots, leaves or barks. So this color, they used color dyes, no? This color were made from the extract of roots, leaves or barks. These natural dyes were made used in rock paintings. It's clear, children? Next one, we are going to see. See this picture, hunting scene in which men and women are taking part. Already we studied people, early people or early men, they lived in caves. So caves, there is a rocks. So in the rocks, they painted pictures. So what are the theme or what are they telling the story? So what means? Hunting scenes, they painted the hunting scenes in which men and women are taking part. Men and women taking part in the hunting scene, so they painted. Next one, Asian rock paintings. Asian rock paintings. In India, we can see many paintings in rocks and caves. In India, we can see many paintings in rocks and caves. The rock paintings give some information about the past. The rock paintings give some information about the past. Approximately there are 750 caves in India. Approximately there are 750 caves in which 500 caves have painted. Among the 750 caves, 500 caves have painted. Paintings. There are many more undiscovered caves. So there are many more undiscovered caves. The rock paintings depict hunting pictures of the male and female, dancing pictures and pictures of children playing. What are the pictures they painted? Hunting pictures of male and female. Dancing pictures, they danced, no? Dancing pictures and pictures of children playing. These three kinds of pictures they drawn in the caves. Okay, next one. From nomadic to settled life. Already we studied nomadic. What is the meaning of nomadic children? Nomadic life means not proper life. They are not settled in particular place. They are moving from one place to another. That is called nomadic. So, from nomadic life to they settled in particular place. Settled in particular place. That is called settled life. Settled life. The world's earliest farmers. The world's earliest farmers. The seed of fruits and nuts. The seeds of fruits and nuts they ate were thrown into the soil. They ate fruits and nuts from the trees, no? They plucked fruits and they ate. After eating, they thrown into the soil or thrown into the ground. Okay. During rains, the soil give it life. During rainy times, the soil give it life. It life means what? Gives life for seeds. Some days later, the saplings sprouted from the soil. Some days later, the seeds, no? They grown. The saplings sprouted from the soil. By observation and logic, they learned that. What are they learned? First one, a plant grows from a single seed. They learned, first point, a plant grows from a single seed and yields lot of fruits and vegetables. This is the first point the early men learnt. Second one, seeds that fall in the river beds sprout easily. Seeds that fall in the river beds sprout easily. This is the second point they learnt. Third one, plants grow faster in water-fed areas. Plants grow faster in water-fed areas. This is the third point they learned. Fourth one, alluvial soil is more suitable for plant growth than any other. Alluvial soil is more suitable for plant growth than any other. These are all the four points the early man observed or learned. Okay. Next one. With the above knowledge, they realized that with proper sowing and nurturing, they would increase the number of plants more than the ones that grow naturally. Thus, agriculture and farming came into existence. So, these are all the four ideas they got idea for farming. They domesticated the animals and used them in their farming. So, the early men started to agriculture with the help of animals. Okay, with the help of animals. Next one. Prehistoric rock art of Tamil Nadu. Prehistoric rock art of Tamil Nadu. Keerwalai in Viluppuram district. These are the rock paintings or rock art. We can say rock art also or rock paintings also. So, first place Keerwalai in Viluppuram district. Here, Usilambatti in Madurai district. Next one, Kumudipadi in Coimbatore district. Mavadaipu in Coimbatore district. These two, Porivare cave in Karikeyur, Nilgiri district. These are all the caves place. Early men draw the pictures with the help of dyes, color dyes. They used leaves, seeds, fruits, colors, no? They used. These are all the places, prehistoric rock art of Tamil Nadu. Okay, children. Next one, the invention of plough helped farming practices. The invention of plough helped the farming practices. Farming started with the clearing of land and burning the leftover shrubs. The leftover shrubs. Now also, after cultivating the sugar cane, the roots are present in the land, no? So the people, the farmers want to burn the roots. So the same method the Asian people also they followed. Human stayed on the plains for a long time. Before and all, the early man stayed in mountains, caves and all, no? So they came down, they stayed on the plains for a long time. During this period, they have not only learnt agriculture, but slowly developed skills of handicraft. So, beginning, they learnt only agriculture. Afterwards, slowly developed skills of handicraft. Permanent settlement in a place increased the yield of crops. Afterwards, they permanent settlement in a particular place increased the yield of crops. Now, they had grains in excess of what they consumed. Afterwards, they cultivate properly, they do the agriculture properly, they get more grains. Okay, the surplus grains were exchanged with other groups for other things they were in need of. This is called the barter system. Barter system means without money they exchanging the food materials or grains. Okay, without money, that is called barter system. Thus trade and commerce developed and towns and cities emerged. Okay, children, next one. See, the invention of wheel. In this lesson, we studied these two points. The invention of wheel is considered to be the foremost invention. So, wheel invention is very important. Is the foremost invention. Foremost means, already I told, foremost means very important invention. It made pot making easier. So, the wheel made pot very easier. We get knowledge about the past lifestyle through rock paintings. Thank you, children.